Good afternoon, guys. Welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to be going over what has happened to the OG Cat Eye here. And really, it's not that anything has happened, it's the lack of things happening to the Cat Eye. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. All right, so if you remember, many weeks ago, before the burnout truck was even in existence, this is the 6L we bought for the Cat Eye. So if you have forgotten or you didn't see, we blew the Cat Eye up at Cletus and Cars, Bradenton, back at the end of November. Since then, it has sat here with no engine in it, waiting for the 6L to be rebuilt. Well, we were underway with that. We pulled it out. I bought the 6L and stuff like that for it, but everything kind of ceased. And reason being is the burnout truck came into existence. Now, originally I thought it's not gonna be a big deal. I'll put a little bit of money there, a little bit of money here, we'll even it out and it'll be good. Well, the problem with that is the next Cletus and Cars is in April 4th, and it didn't give us a ton of time. And to some people that may sound like a long time, but when you're trying to do like build something like that, it takes way more time than you could ever imagine. So I put all of my resources into the burnout truck, and they're currently still in the burnout truck. We're not done, we're not there yet with it. There's still money going into it, there's still our time being invested into it. So the burnout truck has basically sucked all the money that could potentially be going into the Cat Eye and put it into it. Now, with that being said, the burnout truck, even though we still have a lot to do, it is nearing completion. It is probably maybe 5 weeks out from being pretty much ready, and the biggest money spent, it'll just be odds and ends thing that take time to do. So because of that, we can get started back on the Cat Eye. So what I want to do, and actually this was supposed to go to a machine shop, ended up not going to the one I wanted to, and we changed it up. I've been waiting on this one guy who's going to take care of it for us to become available. He has notified me that he is available and he's ready for it. He just wants it completely torn down. So what I'm doing today, it's completely pulling apart the 6L. So I need to get the rotating assembly out of it, which includes the crank, the pistons, cam, lifters, old paintings come off of it. And basically he just wants the block and the crank. That is all that we're gonna be reusing from the original engine here. Of course, we're gonna have new pistons and stuff like that. So I'm gonna get Austin over here and him and I are gonna tear this thing down real quick. And once we get this torn down, I'll kind of go through and reiterate of all the parts we're gonna be putting into this and the plans for other stuff here on the Cat Eye build. So give us a little bit of time to tear this thing down and we'll go over some of the parts.
Some issues getting the cam out, and this is a cam bearing. It's not as thick as a main bearing, that was, but it was jacked up, and this is definitely what probably caused this motor to end its life. So I bent it to get it out, but it was not in much better shape than this.
Yeah, no, definitely the cam bearings are definitely what is shot in the 6L. So that would probably lead me to believe why it was pulled out or whatever it was. It probably lost its oil pressure. due to that, but there it is. The block is completely torn down and it's ready to go to a machine shop and get all taken care of. Now, here's the good stuff. Let me get into what the final plan is for the cat eye. This has been with me thinking about it and stuff like that. This is the final decision. This is the build list we're gonna go with. And this is the plan. So let me give you the rundown. Alrighty guys, so we've decided to move to the whiteboard approach here at the shop to show progress and what still needs to be done. So nothing has really been done on the cat eye, so everything still exists. So, and some of it will be a little bit repetitive for those of you that have stuck around, but this is the final decision. Flat top pistons. So if we can go with the stock bore, we'll probably go with the stock bore and not bore it out if it cleans up good. If it doesn't, we may have to bore it out to clean it up, which it doesn't look like or appear it has any scarring or marring down inside of the cylinder walls. But we'll see what the machine shop has to say about that. Big cam, probably gonna do the 228 R cam from Texas Speed. May even do their Chop Monster. I guess it's just gonna depend. I'm worried about the drivability of the Chop Monster, so that may be kind of out, but the 228 looks a little appealing. We're probably gonna go that route. Brand new headers, because you know the burnout truck stole the headers off of this truck. So we're gonna do inches 7/8 Texas Speed headers this go around. Check the heads. So the heads are actually going to somebody that specializes in heads locally, and they're gonna go through them, make sure that nothing has went wrong, none of the seals, and the valve hasn't been hit when the wrist pin, the rods let loose, and the pistons didn't hit any of the valves or anything like that. So they're gonna go over the 862 heads, and those are we're gonna use the stage 2.553 heads on them, which those are the 62cc combustion chamber. So we're definitely talking about big compression between the flat tops and doing the heads with the smaller combustion chamber. 90 millimeter throttle body, I'm gonna get that fixed this go around, because you know we've been running the Trailblazer SS intake manifold, which will run on the 6.0. Definitely gonna put the 90 millimeter on it. We want all the airflow we can get. 39 pound injectors, those are the Fast LSX, or just Fast, I think they're made by Fast. Fast injectors, I've got the 39 pounds, already have them here, so we can put those in once we get to the point. Once we get to that point, I've got Glenn's Auto Performance fuel rails that went around the Trailblazer SS intake manifold. Torque converter, still have to talk with Texas. And see, the torque converter is going to depend on the cam, so we'll go with the proper converter install needed for the cam in which we decided to go with. So that's why I didn't put a stall here, but definitely big torque converter. HD hood and grill, you know we already have the HD hood outside. I just got to get the grill for it, and I'll probably just buy a brand new grill, so don't worry about telling me where to use one is. I'm just going to buy a brand new one for this truck. New tires, obviously. Two tires are completely gone, and the other two really don't have that much tread, so we're gonna stick with the wheels. I think I'm gonna keep the wheels another season. I may actually legitimately have them polished the right way, make them look really good for this season, but put new tires on them. 456 gears, we're gonna be spinning them big old 35 1250s again on the 22 by 12s. We're gonna go 456. It's not a highway truck, so it doesn't hurt my feelings if we turn a little bit more RPMs. Dyno tune needs to be retuned, so we'll probably have whoever does the burnout truck do that. Bigger trans cooler, we're gonna do the 40K cooler right here. We may even put a fan on it. We may even have the big cooler here and a fan behind it. So to keep it nice and cool and not have an overheating issue, especially if we decide to go with a big stall converter. We definitely wanna have as much cooling as we possibly can. So that is the main gist of what needs to be done. Ultimately, when you think about it, it's not a massive list, it's just an expensive list. When you start adding in the components like the headers, cam, and flat tops, you've probably just went at least $1,500, maybe more like $1,800. You pay somebody to check the heads a couple hundred. We've got that. That's $500 no matter what. I mean, that's starting $500 for a converter. That's not really gonna cost that much. We're talking probably about $2,000 for a set of tires to get what I want. That's not gonna be cheap. We're probably looking at, I don't know, front and rear, it's gonna be a fortune. Dyno tune, about $500. Bigger trans cooler, not too bad, couple hundred bucks. So the problem with this list is it's extremely expensive. It's not really long, it's just really pricey. So that's the problem with, that's the biggest problem with this list. So like I said, we're gonna get back on this once the burnout truck is complete. I just wanted to give you guys an update because I know a lot of you guys have been asking about it, and it definitely hasn't been abandoned or forgotten. It's right here, and I look at it every day I come inside of the shop. comes to the door, and I want to, I even climb up inside of it and sit in it occasionally because I want to be driving it again. But the weather's still kind of crappy here in Virginia. It's still cold, so I'm not missing it too much, but I'm definitely missing it enough to try to hurry up and get back on with it. So hope you enjoyed the video. If you got any questions, you can drop them down in the comment section below. Don't forget to follow me over on Instagram at Austin04_Z71. And like I said at the beginning of the video, if you're not already, please hit that subscribe button. Check out the other videos on the channel. I appreciate all you guys watching. I appreciate your support as always. Take care. Have a great day.